The member for Barman.
Well, thank you, Deputy Speaker, and it's an opportunity tonight for us to recognise the extraordinary contribution made by the cruise liner industry in Australia, a $3.2 billion industry, and I'm probably one of the first people to rise in this place and say thank you on behalf of the millions who have enjoyed a cruise at an affordable price for a unique and special experience. But there's another level of this debate that's been brought to light in New South Wales, and I do want to highlight that Australia is probably the last major economy in the world. Certainly, we stand apart from the EU, the Caribbean and the Americas in that our cruise ships visiting Australian ports are burning the thick black stuff and not the clear stuff. We need to get these emissions down in all our cities. It happens in the rest of the world. And I think tonight is an opportunity for us to appeal to the cruise ship liner industry to do just that and to do it through corporate social responsibility and not through further regulation. Just this week, we have had an announcement from the Coalition New South Wales Government, the Liberal Government in New South Wales, that as soon as possible after this week's election, they intend to reduce regulation to require cruise ships at berth in New South Wales to use ultra-low sulphur diesel with a sulphur content of less than 100 parts per million. And by July of next year, they will be moving that cruise ships use low sulphur diesel at all times in Australian areas, certainly in zones around major ports. I commend New South Wales for that, but I ask the logical question, what happens in the rest of Australia? This is a federal issue, but more importantly than anything, it's an opportunity for the cruise ship industry to step forward and do something as a form of corporate social responsibility. Now, I acknowledge the economic impacts of cruise ship liners in major cities. I acknowledge the impact in regional economies like Townsville, like Burnie, like parts of Western Australia and up the Queensland coast. But above all, I think about the fact that it's no one's fault that there is high density living right next to cruise ship liners and where these overseas terminals exist. It's no fault of anyone's that people want to live next door to where these large shipping liners berth. Now, this is far away from ports, and I know the objections from the cruise ship industry about burning clean fuel. And they are predominantly based around price, that there's a 16 cent litre difference, that the supply is not guaranteed, that they don't all have an auxiliary fuel tank, particularly in older cruise liners, and that the long-term plan is a MARPOL 2020 target of scrubbers. But that is not the answer for residents living close to these shipping terminals right now that have high sulphur fuels being burnt, effectively a bunker oil with 2,700 to 3,500 parts per million, basically burning 100 metres away from where they live. Now, they can't move, and I know that in many cases you might say they might have been there first, but unlike the ports where we have large carriers burning this stuff, they're not in densely populated locations, and to be honest, the ships were there first. But in overseas cruise ship terminals, all I ask is one thing. To the cruise ship industry, do what is affordable, reasonable, feasible. And if you can minimise an emission for the cost of a Big Mac per person, just do it. And don't be dragged to that point and look completely reluctant about it. Now, I've talked to the ship owners, I've talked to the cruise ship industry, and I must admit I've encountered shifting opposition and a whole lot of reasons why they can't do it. But Caltex has popped the bubble. They can deliver it in 5 days. Caltex has told us it's not even half a tanker to refuel one of these shipping liners and make sure that kids living nearby aren't breathing in high particulate, high sulphur matter that turns to sulfuric acid when you breathe it in. It's not good enough in the Industrial Revolution, although it dragged England out of the Middle Ages, but we can do better than having kids working in coal mines. We can do better than having this kind of emission 100 metres away from living areas and high-density residential. New South Wales Coalition can act. So every other state in Australia will be asking exactly the same same question. Why is it good enough that in the EU you can't travel between ports without burning the clean stuff? Why is it that in the US you can't even come near a port without burning the clean stuff? And all of these liners have the clean stuff on board an auxiliary tank, but they won't switch, they won't flick the switch. And why is it? Because it costs a Big Mac meal deal per person. It's a $4,000 cruise ship ticket. It's $8 to burn the clean stuff. It is such a simple request, and I'm stunned that when you're sitting around a boardroom table discussing your corporate social responsibility, that someone's still saying in a 1970s attitude, whatever you want for corporate social responsibility, long as it doesn't hurt our bottom line. Well, this one barely hurts your bottom line. This stuff is 16 cents a litre cheaper. This stuff should not be burnt in a public close to where people live. This stuff is revolting.
I ask the member to refrain. We can do better than that.
We can burn the clear stuff. It's eminently available. We should be using that and not this. And I insist on the cruise ship industry to clean up their act and burn the clean stuff like they do in the rest of the world.